Check, check. Can you hear me? Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Bleckel Center. Thanks for joining us on MountMaryAthletics.com for today's Division III Women's Basketball Contest featuring the Marion University Sabres and the Mount Mary University Blue Angels. Blue Angels head into today's game with a record of 1-2, while Marion enters the game at season record of 1-0. My name is Clint Andreessen, alongside with my partner Brett Burke. Brett, what are some keys to look at for today's game?
Well, the Sabres, as you said, are coming into the game 1-0 after defeating Lawrence University 57-28. The defensive effort from Marion held Lawrence 10 first half points, teaming with an offensive awakening in the first quarter where the Sabres went 8 of 15 from the field and shot 4 of 7 from behind the three-point line. The Blue Angels have been energized by Becky Onan's recent performances. Onan comes into the basketball season just days after she finished season with the soccer team and leading the team with 16 points per game, 8.3 rebounds per game, and 1.3.
All right, and we'll send it down to the PA announcer for today's national anthem and starting lineups. All right, Brett, as the PA address announcer reads the lineups here, we'll go off with the lineups. First for the Marion University Sabres, starting at guard, a 5'7 junior from Belgium, Wisconsin, number 5, Nicole Paulus. At guard, a 5'5 freshman from Union Grove, Wisconsin, number 10, Jordan Widener. At guard, a 5'6 sophomore from Marcuson, Wisconsin, number 12, Brandy Bender. At forward, a 6-foot senior from DePere, Wisconsin, number 34, Lindsay Vogels. And at forward, a 5'8 sophomore from Neenah, Wisconsin, number 41, Brittany Bauman. The Sabres are coached by Bill Peters and assisted by Rachel Lugin, Sarah Olowinski, and Chuck Schutte.
In for the Mount Mary Blue Angels, at guard, number 3, Jess Runge. At guard from Atlanta, Georgia, number 10, Shandrika Richardson. At guard from Shawano, Wisconsin, number 12, Ariel Oviedo. At guard from West Allis, number 14, Katie Swafford. And at forward, number 34, from Grafton, Wisconsin, Becky Onan. Head coach, Mark Heidorf, and the assistant is Philip Van Ermen.
All right, and as our PA adjustment announcer just finishes the starting lineup here, what are the keys for you in today's game?
I would say the key is to get Becky Onan started early. She's been coming off the bench for two of the first three games, and she's been their biggest contributor on the court so far in terms of points and rebounds. They need to play good defense, as the Sabres didn't give up many points in their first game, and it's going to be a big thing for Mount Mary to be able to keep up with the Sabres if it turns into an offensive contest.
Absolutely. And as Brett mentioned earlier, Marion only gave up 10 points in the first half of their first game this year. They defeated Lawrence University a couple of days ago. And like you said, the defense is going to be key for Marion, I believe.
Yeah, The Sabres were up 18 after the first quarter in their first game, and if you're Mount Mary, you can't put yourself in that deficit after 10 minutes. You got four quarters, and you got to keep it a tight game until the end, and you hope you can pull one out.
Absolutely. All right, we're about ready to get going here. As you can see, Mount Mary will be wearing their home whites, while Marion is in the road royal blues. Just set to tip off here. And the tip goes to Marion. Reiner sets up the offense. She kicks it to Bauman. Bauman on the wing. Swings it over. This is Lindsay Vogel. Here's Widener now. Back over. This is Bender. Bender now at the top of the key. Good defense here by Mount Mary. 3-point basket there by Nicole Harris.
And that was good defense by the Blue Angels, playing zone, keeping them outside, never really letting them penetrate the paint.
Yeah, interesting that they came out with a little 2-3 zone. Maybe to match up with that size from Marion. We've got a foul called there. That will go against Jordan Widener, her first personal foul. Team's first. As Mount Mary will take it on side out. And it looks like we just have a little delay. It looks like the shot clock was reset. And here we go. This is Oviedo setting up the offense. Freshman here. Back to Oviedo. Now Rungi. Rungi played all 40 minutes in their last home game. And a traveling violation called early on the Mount Mary. Like we said right away, looks like Marion's playing some tough defense to start.
Yeah, there wasn't really any penetration on that first series. They didn't really have any place to get the ball inside to own in.
Here's Widener. She swings it around. This is Brandy Bender. Little jump shot, no good. Rebounded by Katie Swafford. And Swafford will bring it up. Jess Rungi looks inside and resets the offense. Here's Oviedo on the side, off the screen. And Swafford puts up a three. That one's off the backboard. Rebounded by Widener. And the Sabres bring it back. Drive baseline here by Brittany Bauman. And she is fouled. She'll go to the line.
Mount Mary's doing a good job of keeping the Sabres on the perimeter, not allowing them to use the dribble drive to go to the hole. And even on that attempt there where they did get to the hole, made sure they didn't get the layup and made a hard foul.
Here's Brittany Bauman at the line. The first free throw is good. A 5'8 sophomore from Neenah, Wisconsin. One of the few returners for Marion this afternoon. A little scramble there for the loose ball, but it looks like Mount Mary has come up with it. And Rungi will bring up and set up the offense. Rungi now in the corner. Swafford here in the four-guard offense for the Mount Mary. Into Onan. Back out to Oviedo. Jump shot's no good.
Onan's having a hard time getting separation from Vogels as she's the smaller of the two, which is something you don't see very often.
Absolutely. She tends to tower over her opponents most of the time, but that's not the case today. We'll see if the Blue Angels here can set up some offense, maybe get something going here. Looked like the ball might have been tipped away, but it looks like it's just an errant pass. Another turnover for the Blue Angels. Good pressure there by Richardson. Here's Bender now at the top of the key. Over to Widener. Cut there by Nicole Pilot. She brings it back out. Finds the cutting. Bender for the easy two.
It's a real good cut by Widener there to get to the hole. Mount Mary had been keeping the cuts mostly outside of the paint, and that one got back door and got to the open spot in the defense.
Yeah, good look there by Pilot to find Bender on the cut. We had a turnover there. A little mishap on the inbounds. So the ball will come back to the Sabres. Here's Bobbin now in the post. She works on Richardson and the foul.
Tough for Richardson at 5'3 to guard Bauman at 5'8, especially in the post. That's not the best matchup for the Blue Angels.
Yeah, exactly. That's a tough matchup there for a point guard by trade, basically. There's Bauman at the line for one more. She converts on the and one. Just about 7 minutes to go here in the first quarter. Sabres lead it here 9-0 as Richardson drives baseline. And she's bodied and draws the foul.
A good cut there. She had the opening. She had a chance at the basket. The foul just came before she had a chance to put it up.
Here's Onan now. Ball stripped away, out of bounds. Last touch by the Sabres. As Runge will set to inbound. She finds Onan, and Oviedo sets up the offense here. Off the screen is Richardson. She drives middle. Ball stripped. Lost her for a moment. Now she finds Taylor York. Off the mark. Taken by the Sabres. They come.
Good step up by Runge to stop the fast break and force the turnover in the end when the travel violation.
There you go, yep. Yeah, for the lack of size that Mount Mary possesses, they are very stingy on the defensive end. We saw that in their first win last weekend. Very, very difficult to score on when they're set in the defense. Here's Richardson now on the left key, on the left wing. She finds Onan. Now back to Richardson off the handoff. She's bodied, falls to the ground. And Mount Mary recovers it here. Fresh shot clock for the Blue Angels. Here's Richardson on the wing. She looks inside. Looks like the ball is kicked away. Last touch by the Sabres.
No space inside the three-point line, really, for the Blue Angels to go to, and they're having a hard time scoring points with the 18, 19-foot jump shots.
Yeah, yeah, very, very tough to get inside against the Sabres team early on. Sub checking in for the Sabres. That's 31 Jessica Roberts, a 5'9 junior from Oshkosh, as she sees her first minutes with just under six remaining in the first quarter. York spins. She looks. Here's Oviedo now. She kicks it back out. Onan off the screen. Looked to drive there, but shuffled her feet. Traveling violation called there by the referee. Very tough early on here for the Blue Angels to score, it looks like.
Yeah, trying to get the dribble drive going and running picks and screens and coming off the pick and going to the paint, and there's just no space for them to pass the ball successfully so far.
Here's Paul down on the drive, and she's called for a travel. A lot of travels early on here.
Teams are a little quick to get to the hole.
Yeah. Here's Runge walking the ball up the court. 5'4 junior from Freedom. Point guard looks to set the offense. Here's Onan now to Oviedo. Off the screen by Onan. Kicks it to Runge. Now back to Oviedo. Onan on the baseline. She drives. Shot's no good. Rebounded by Roberts. Sabres look to push here. Bauman drives to the paint. Pulls up for the jumper, and that one is good.
Had to come out late to put the pressure on the shooter, and nobody rotated over to cover in the paint. Ends up in an easy two-point basket for the Sabres.
Bauman with a good start early on. A few baskets and a trip to the foul line so far for her. Here's Oviedo with the drive in the lane. She's off the mark.
Seemed like there was a little more space that time. It looked like they weren't man-to-man. It looked like there was a little more zone. Not really sure what. It was just a line, but.
There's Bauman for three. Brittany Bauman with the three-point basket. She's bringing the offense early here for the Sabres. Yeah, Runge looks to stop the offense. Here's Onan now to Richardson. Back to Onan. Onan with the jumper. That one's no good. In and out.
I'd say that's their first good quality look, though. You got a good pass to an open Onan, and she had a good chance at an easy basket. Just didn't fall.
Here's the Sabres now running the offense. Widener with the drive. Off the glass and puts it in.
Good ball fake to the left there by Widener to get the hole open and just nobody in the middle to stop her on the easy layup.
Tough stretch to start the game here for the Blue Angels. 16-0 our score here, just over 3 minutes to play in the first quarter. Oviedo off the screen. And it looks like a foul off the ball. That will go against Nicole Paulus of the Sabres.
And Paulus, their leading scorer in game one, hasn't really gotten involved yet so far, so that's a good job by the Blue Angels to shut her down. It's just other people are stepping up and making them pay.
Yeah, absolutely. Paulus comes in from last year, averaging 16 points a game. Excuse me. Correction, no, that was 8 points a game last year. She comes in as the team's returning leading scorer. She also scored 19 points in their opener this year. But yeah, today it's been all Brittany Bauman so far for the Sabres.
Yeah, the Blue Angels have done a good job of keeping them outside of the paint, really, except for the last two trips down the court, and the Sabres have just knocked down the shot so far, shooting a high percentage. They're making them work. The Blue Angels are making them work for it when they do get in the paint, but they need to hope or play more pressure defense closer to the three-point line as it's costing them right now.
Yeah. We'll take a break here. Looks like we have a media timeout with about 3.5 remaining in the first quarter. Brett, if you don't mind talking about the rule change for Division III women's basketball this year. We've got a rule change where it's instead of two halves, now we have four quarters, similar to NBA game or a WNBA game.
Yeah, I think college basketball in general is getting a lot closer, and especially with women's college basketball, you got the four quarters. You're allowed. It's a little quicker pace. I don't think teams are getting as tired from watching here and watching other women's college basketball games. The 30-second shot clock definitely helps out too. Like, I know the men's were 35, they're now 30 as well, and I think the uniformity of the game around is going to help with scoring, especially on the women's side.
Absolutely. We've seen some high scoring, at least from one side today, this afternoon, but it has been fast-paced very early on here in the first quarter. Looks like we're about set to back ready for action. We'll just reset the lineup here for the Mount Mary Blue Angels. On the floor, we've got Runge out there with Oviedo. Richardson is out there with Onan, and checking in, number 32, Taja Williams.
And for Marion, you have Brittany Bauman out there, Jordan Widener, Jessica Roberts, Hunter Godfrey, and Molly Kovarik.
Here is Kovarik for three.
Comes right off the bench and knocks down a big three to extend the lead to 19 for the Sabres.
Yeah, good first quarter here for the Sabres so far. Tough going for the Blue Angels as Onan drives. She gets the first one to go for the Blue Angels on a drive. Nice play there by Becky Onan.
Yeah, the last couple times down when they've gotten the ball to Onan, she's gone to her left hand and she's had a chance to get to the hole, and just that was the first one she's successful on, but it's been open these last couple possessions.
And there's a block by Onan. Sabres recover as they kick it to Bauman. The third layup is no good, and Oviedo brings it across the timeline. Runge looks to set the offense here. Here's Oviedo. Oviedo drives. Good help there by the Sabres.
Tough break there with really no room to go and trying to force it a little bit, but somebody needs to start the offense, as 2 points so far in the first quarter isn't going to cut it.
Yeah, I don't think Coach Hardoff minds the aggressiveness there, even though they were calling for the offensive foul. And the Blue Angels look to extend this zone pressure here a little bit.
good 2-on-2 half-court press there that made the Sabres hesitate in the backcourt.
Yeah, we've seen that from time to time from the Blue Angels. They like to extend that zone pressure out near half-court. Looks like a little bit of a double team. But now they're back in man as the Sabres look to score here.
And Oviedo, who's been a big ball handler so far, had to come off for blood on her elbow. So see who takes the reins for the Blue Angels offense next time down.
That shot there by Jessica Roberts as she's able to connect on the jump shot. Here's Onan now on the left side again. York thought about it. Now dishes it off. Ruggie looks inside. Here's Williams. She throws one up.
Looked like good effort there to try to get the jump ball back in your own offensive zone, and they would have retained possession, but tough luck gets called a foul, and it's Sabres ball.
Yeah. You can't knock the intensity and the effort by the Blue Angels so far this afternoon. Just not able to get the ball in the basket too many times so far. Sabres straight around. There's Bauman again for three. That one's off the backboard. And Rungy out in front of everyone. Kind of loses the handle.
Little kick there by Onan to try to get it back to Rungy, but I think the back ref saw it there at the end.
Yeah. I think Becky might have thought she was still playing soccer. She's an outstanding goalie and a goal scorer for the Blue Angels soccer team. Tried to use a little bit of her skills to cross over for today's game, but the referee caught it there. Bauman drives in. She kicks it to Roberts.
Good pressure.
Is off the mark. And as you said, good pressure there by the Blue Angels.
I really like the trap defense. It's disrupted the Sabres offense a little bit, and it's going to cause them to figure out a new way to get to the basket, as they've already put up 21 points, but a lot of that came in the first 7 minutes of the game.
Ball was lost on the drive there by Richardson, but Blue Angels retain the possession. Under a minute to play here in the first quarter. Here's Rungy now, out to York. She looks inside. Pass into Becky Onan, tipped away. Good play there by Molly Kvorek as the Sabres bring it up and look to reset.
Yeah, Kvorek's come in off the bench and done a good job so far knocking down the three and keeping Onan from getting started when she's the biggest, best point scorer on the Blue Angels.
And there's another bucket there by Brittany Bauman, having a good first quarter offensively for the Sabres. Rungy drives in. Her shot's good. Good floater there by Jess Rungy. And a last second heave attempt by Brandy Bender there as the first quarter ends. Our score after one, Sabres of Marion 23 and Mount Mary University Blue Angels 4.
Yeah, as you said just a minute ago, Bauman has had a big first half. Or first quarter, comes in only averaging 6 points last year. So she's really stepped up her game so far. I want to say she's probably got 8 or 10 points so far already in the first quarter.
At least, yeah. And as you said, it would be a good first half, but it is only the first quarter. I mean, that would be a good first half, I think, for most people in the stat columns. But yeah, good first quarter there by Bauman and the Sabres as they put the pressure on the Blue Angels.
Definitely most likely for Bauman having a career game so far. And we still got 30 minutes left to play. Who knows what could happen? I think Blue Angels are going to recognize that she's really been the killer and they need to step out and make somebody else do the work.
Yeah. Do you see any changes that the Blue Angels are going to make? Do you think that they will make any changes for this second quarter here defensively?
I think they'll stick with their 2-on-2 trap zone half-court press idea. It really disrupted the Sabres over the last 2 minutes or so, as it was, I want to say it was 19-0 with 7 minutes in. So over the last 3 minutes, they only gave up 4 points, scored four. And offensively, I think you got to keep trying to go to the hole. Eventually, you're going to find a gap. Somebody's going to get in foul trouble. You're going to be shooting free throws, and you only need to get to five in the quarters now to get to the double bonus.
Correct. Yeah, absolutely. Looks like we're about to set back for action here. And here's Oviedo back in the ballgame now after coming out with that injury. Looks like the feet were shuffled a little bit there by Swafford as the referee calls another traveling violation there.
Right ideas on a lot of those travels, just a little quick before getting the ball down.
All right, the Sabres start the offense. Here is Paulus over to Widener. Her pass is tipped away by Onan. Good defensive play. Good effort there by Ariel Oviedo.
Yeah, Oviedo's really been high energy for all the whole game so far, and except for the time when she had to come out. She's really been the main ball controller for the Blue Angels.
Here's the Sabres with the shot clock running down. That three-point attempt by Sarah Schultz off the mark, but rebounded by the Sabres as Paulus slides in the lane and gets that one to fall. Mount Mary works the offense, swings it around the perimeter. Oviedo looks inside, now drives. Kicks out to Richardson. Richardson is stripped. Dive on the floor for the loose ball. Jump ball. Looks like the possession arrow will go with Marion University.
I think the height disadvantage here is really hurting Mount Mary as they can't make the cross-court pass to the open person, and they don't have those easy shots. They have to do a lot of work on the inside, and they haven't been able to get there yet.
Absolutely. It's definitely difficult when you're playing a four-guard set against some of these bigs that Marion has out on the floor.
Yeah, and Marion, 7 of the 10 players are 5'7 or taller, whereas for Mount Mary, the only one over 5'6 is Becky Onan, and you're really at a height disadvantage here. Every player on Marion really has the advantage physically, and it's been the biggest factor so far for the Sabres.
Absolutely. Good defensive play there by Becky, but looks like she kind of got ahead of herself and called for the double dribble, so it's back with the Sabres. Here's Schultz swinging around. This is Widener. Good defense by Swafford. Here's Widener, still drive. Back out. This is Vogels for three. Lindsay Vogel.
Looks like the Blue Angels switched back to man, and Onan was a little late getting back on the rotation after helping inside in case of the dribble drive, and good knockdown three by Vogels.
All right. Mount Mary sets up the offense. Here's Oviedo. Oviedo behind the back. Nice move. And the jumper in the paint hits every part of the rim but gets it to go.
Really nice play there by Oviedo, finally getting one to go on the dribble drive and knocking it down from the elbow.
Sabres here working around. Coach Hunter pretty happy with the defensive effort so far by the Blue Angels.
Yeah, I definitely think the Blue Angels have done all they can defensively so far with the height disadvantage and with the short bench they have. They've played high energy the whole game, and they've kept them out of the paint. The Sabres have just knocked down the threes that they've taken so far.
Absolutely. The Sabres are making the shots when they need them. It's not due to the lack of defensive effort by the Blue Angels. We'll take a timeout here. Just over 7 minutes to play in the second quarter. Our score is 28-6. Marion leads this one here.
Definitely a change from last year for the Sabres, as they only shot 28.9% from three, and they got to be well over that today so far. As you said, not a lot of returners for the Sabres, but the ones that have returned are making a big impact.
Yeah, absolutely. That was Lindsay Vogels, who just made that three-point shot. She's a senior, a 6-foot senior from DePere, Wisconsin. But yeah, getting a contribution really from a lot of their returning players so far this afternoon.
Yeah, and Vogel's a player that only played 10 minutes a game last year, averaged 1.5 points a game, so wasn't really a contributor to a Sabres team that went 12-13, but looks much better so far this year.
And we've kind of seen that across the board from the Sabres. We saw Brittany Bomber, they have a great first quarter. And as you said, she wasn't too big of a factor last year, but comes in today.
Yeah, she only shot 40% from the field last year, averaged 6 points a game, and today she's already got 8 or 10 points at least, and I'd say she's 5 of 7 from the field.
Yeah.
Got to the free throw line a couple times and really been a big factor for the Sabres.
We'll reset the lineups here quickly as we get back to action. Rungy is out there with Oviedo for the Blue Angels, Yort and Richardson along with Onan. And as for Marion, we've got Paulus out there with Widener. Bender is out there with Godfrey. And Lindsay Bogles rounds out the Sabres lineup. Shot made there by Nicole Paulus, but before the shot, called for a travel.
Yeah, needed one last step, tried to get into her shooting motion. It was just a little too far away when the pass was delivered.
Rungy looks to set the offense. Here's Onan. Off to Richardson. Back to Rungy. Rungy through the lane. Looked like there might have been some contact there, but...
Yeah, a tough drive by Rungy for no foul to be called. It looked like both Sabres players hacked her, but ball's now at the other end.
Sabres work the offense here. Paulus looked inside. Found Bender as she draws the foul. That one's on Ariel Oviedo. Her second personal foul. And a good defensive play by Rungy as she strips that one on
the
inbound.
Yeah, great read on the inbound pass, something a lot of teams just take for granted, and Rungy jumped it and got a good turnover for the Blue Angels.
She comes off the screen here. And now back out to Richardson. Richardson resets. One good thing here about the Mount Mary offense is Onan has it on the wing. Richardson puts up a three. Long rebound there by the Sabres. I was going to say the one good thing for the Blue Angels offense, they've got a lot of guards who can run the offense. It really doesn't matter who's handling the ball.
Yeah, only really one true forward in the sense of their roster, as everybody else is under 5'6". And can handle the ball pretty well, and even Onan handles the ball pretty well.
Absolutely.
Another good thing, they did finally get a cross-court pass there, and Onan just decided not to take the three, something that she hasn't done often this year. She's 4 of 7 when she has, so maybe it's something to look forward to the rest of the game.
Yeah. On the other end, a three-point basket there by Nicole Paulus, and then we had a turnover as the ball was dribbled out of bounds, so they'll come back with the Sabres. Here's Paulus now, over to Vogels. Vogels looks. Pretty good defense again by the Blue Angels. Here's Paulus now, she'll throw one up from three, no good. And Onan skies for the rebound there.
Good pressure continuing by the Blue Angels as they... The last 8 minutes have been good. They've only been outscored 12-6 in the last 8 minutes. It was those first seven that really killed them so far.
Here's Rungy now on the baseline. She'll kick to Richardson. Richardson with the shot. No good. A little scramble for the ball there. And before the rebound, looks like we've got a loose ball foul on the Sabres.
Seems like the Blue Angels are starting to flow. They're often starting to flow a little bit better, and they're getting those drives underneath and then kick out to the wing. And Richardson, the last two times down, has had a good look from the baseline.
A couple substitutions there for the Sabres. Brittany Bauman returns, as well as Samantha Smits, a 5'4 freshman from Antigo, Wisconsin. Here's Onan with the jumper off the base, or off the inbound. No good. Rebounded by Oviedo, and she puts that one in off the glass.
Good rebound, way to go into the contact and not let it affect her shot on the way up, and Oviedo gets rewarded with a bucket.
Sabres work the offense. as Godfrey throws up a three. No good. Rebounded by Onan.
Threes haven't fallen as much for the Sabres in this quarter, and Blue Angels are being able to make a little bit of a charge and keep a good defensive game going so far.
Just under 4 minutes to play here in the first half. Sabres lead it here 31-8 over the Blue Angels as Onan lines up a three off the mark.
Even though that didn't go in, it's a good look.
It definitely is. Rebounded there by Nicole Paulus for the Sabres. Yeah. Onan really likes that shot at the top of the key. Good drive there by Brittany Bauman as she draws the foul. And the foul called there on Taylor York for the Blue Angels, her first. And she is replaced by Taja Williams in the Blue Angels lineup.
Runge, for the second time on as many attempts, I believe, comes up with steal on the inbounds pass, just loses it out of bounds.
Here's the Sabres now as they work the offense. Looks like a little too much contact there for the referee as he calls the foul. That's on Ariel Oviedo, her third personal foul.
Yeah, that's something definitely over the last couple of years in all of basketball that refs have been cracking down on is the hand check, and Oviedo just got a little too aggressive there trying to stop the Sabres ball handler.
And with her third foul, she's replaced in the Blue Angels lineup by Taylor York. Jessica Roberts also came in for the Sabres as the Sabres work the offense around the outside. Kicked into Roberts. She kicks it back out. That's Brandy Bender with the three-point attempt there. Pulled down by the Blue Angels.
Good work there from Williams and York to keep the ball on the baseline where she couldn't get the easy layup on the inside.
And a good play there by Paulus as she steals it there. Runge slides in for the steal. She's called for the foul. Pretty good play there by Jess Runge.
Yeah, she's definitely... She doesn't seem tired. She's played a lot of minutes, and she continues to put forward high energy and really be a big factor on the defensive end with two steals so far and just missing one there.
Jumper no good off the block. Battle for the rebound. And it looks like it's last touch by Mount Mary. He'll stay with Marion. 27 seconds on the shot clock here. That's Jessica Roberts for three. No good. As Jess Runge pulls in that rebound.
Good news for the Blue Angels is the Sabres are settling for those three-point looks that were falling in the first quarter. Aren't anymore. And this gives them a chance to come back. Especially with the continued drive-in kick out to Richardson that they found to be open the last couple of possessions.
As Richardson knocks down that one off the assist by Runge. Three-point attempt no good by the Sabres. And the putback no good as well. But the Sabres look to reset. They get a third chance here on the offensive end. Smith looks inside to Bauman. She kicks it out to Paulus. Her three-point attempt no good. And another rebound by Jess Runge.
Yeah, tough for, as you saw, the Sabres get the offensive rebound there. It's been really tough with Bauman basically keeping Onan off the glass, and then the rest of the Sabres are taller than the rest of the Blue Angels, so it's been a mismatch all game long.
Looks like it was a little bit of a tie-up there. So a jump ball. Possession arrow stays with the Blue Angels. As Molly Kavorik steps back in for the Sabres, along with Jordan Widener. As Becky Onan will look to inbound here for the Blue Angels. Runge sets the offense here. And now Onan on the wing. Over to Richardson. Richardson drives. Kicks to Williams. And before the shot, looks like we have a traveling violation on Williams.
Good idea there by the Blue Angels. Williams just needs to dribble the ball once, and then she can body up and get that layup inside.
Here's pressure again by the Blue Angels, that little 2-1-2 press, as Bauman looks. Loose ball grabbed by Taylor York, and it will go the other way with the Blue Angels.
And the pressure creates another turnover there, something that the Blue Angels have done really well so far in the second quarter.
Richardson drives baseline. Loose ball gathered up by Onan as she drives baseline, puts up the shot off the rim, no good. And the Sabres look to push. Roberts with the fake, she drives baseline, finds Kovarik.
Tough break there for Richardson. Didn't look like a whole lot of contact, but her position is one of those fouls where if you're behind a shooter, you don't really have much ground for arguing against it.
Yeah. Kovarik now at the line. Molly Kovarik, a 5'10 junior from Walworth. She puts in her first free throw. As Katie Swafford checks back in for the Blue Angels. Kovarik at the line now for one more. And that one is good. Under a minute remaining in the second quarter, Sabres lead it here 33-10. That shot by Runge off the mark.
Really good aggressive this there by Runge, though, even though it didn't result in a basket. It was a good take, and she executed on the opening that she had around the outside.
We get a timeout here by Marion University. Head coach Bill Pierce wants to talk it over with his team. With just under 30 seconds, we've got 23 seconds remaining here in the first half. You like the aggressiveness there by the Blue Angels on that possession, though?
Yeah, the Blue Angels have, as we said earlier, they were down 19-0 at one point. It's now 33-10, so 14-10 over the last quarter and a half, really, for the Blue Angels, and the aggressiveness is paying off. They've created more turnovers. They've finally gotten some open looks on the offensive end, and it's been high energy all day.
Yeah, Coach Mark Hardo can't really argue with that. He loves the energy that his team brings. A lot of new faces here for the Blue Angels this year, with just two returners, which would be Richardson and Onan from last year's team. So it's a good thing that everybody, all the new faces for the Blue Angels are bringing a lot of intensity for Coach Mark. The Sabres here will hold for the last shot of the quarter, as we're under 10 seconds now. Here's Bauman. She looks to line it up. Off to Roberts. Her three-point attempt is no good. Doesn't end up hitting anything, as we've got 0.5 seconds remaining on the clock. It looks like we might just roll this one in, and there we go. It is halftime here in the Buckle Center. Our halftime score, Marion University leaves it here 33-10 over the Mount Mary University Blue Angels. We'll take a break here for halftime, and we'll come back with a few minutes before the start of the second half with the halftime stats. All right, folks, welcome back. I'm Clint Andreessen with alongside my partner Brett Burke, calling the second half here of the Mount Mary University basketball game. They are taking on Marion University Sabres. Our halftime score, Marion leads it here 33-10. As we take a look at the halftime stats.
So first off, as we said much throughout the first half, Brittany Bauman had 11 points, 4 of 6 shooting, 1 of 2 from 3, and 2 or 2 of 3 from the line. And then Nicole Paulus was also a big factor, having 8 points for the Sabres. For Mount Mary, Oviedo was the biggest contributor with 4 points, 2 of 4 from the field. So she's shooting 50%, which is good no matter how many shots you take. Becky Onan struggled a little bit, only had 2 points, 1 of 5 after averaging 16 so far on the young season.
Yeah, it's tough to have much of a scoring output today with when the team has only scored 10 points in the first half. Take a look at the team stats here. For Marion, they out-rebounded Mount Mary by 6 total rebounds. They pulled in 18 in the half. They also came up with 8 assists compared to Mount Mary's 1 lone assist in the first half. The team for Marion shot 44%, while Mount Mary shot about 26% there in the first half.
Yeah, and turnovers are the biggest differential, I would say, from the first half. As, yes, Mount Mary created 9, but they also had 15 of their own, so they weren't really able to execute and trim down the lead on the 9 turnovers they created.
Absolutely, and as we're getting set ready to play, let's just reset the rosters here. First four, the Marion University Sabres. Out on the floor, we've got Brittany Bauman. She's joined by Jordan Widener and Nicole Paulus, as well as Brandy Bender and Lindsay Vogels. And for Mount Mary, we've got Jess Runge out there with Chandrika Richardson, Ariel Oviedo with Katie Swafford, and Becky Onan rounds out the 5 for the Blue Angels as they create an early turnover here to start the third quarter.
Yeah, good way to get out of the break and hopefully start to trim into this lead as you got 20 minutes of basketball left.
We'll see what Mount Mary can do here as Jess Runge brings the ball up the court, sets up the offense for the Blue Angels. Here's Richardson on the wing. She'll look to drive baseline. Kind of lost the handle there on the dribble. And she's tied up. We got our jump ball. Looks like the possession arrow will stay with Mount Mary as we've got 18 seconds on the shot clock. Richardson looks to drive again. Here's Runge and Oviedo. Here's Swafford now swinging it around. Onan inside. She'll look to put it up. And off the glass, she gets that one to go for the first basket of the second half. Becky Onan with her first points of the second half.
Already as many points as she scored in the first half, and that should be a good sign for the Blue Angels that she's off to a hot start so far.
Yeah, let's see if she can get closer to her average, averaging 16 points a game so far this year to go along with 8 rebounds. Here's the Sabres now with under 10 on the shot clock. As Paulus is defended by Runge. Here's Bauman. She kicks out to Widener. She'll drive, throw up a floater. That one's no good. Rebounded by the Blue Angels.
Really good defense there and forced a tough shot. And just everything you want to see if you're Coach Heidorf at the start of the third quarter.
The forward guard set here for Mount Mary swings it around as Oviedo drives through the lane. She puts up a jumper off the backboard, no good. Rebounded by Widener for the Sabres. She'll look to push here. Out to Bauman. Bauman for 3. That one is good.
Picks up where she left off in the first half as she's now up to 14 points so far in the game.
Brittany Bauman with a quick 3 to start the second half here. As we're just over 8 minutes to play in the third quarter. As the Blue Angels swing it around here. This is Oviedo on the wing to Runge. A lot of ball movement, but not too much action on the inside as Swafford looks to drive. Here's Runge. Richardson will have to put one up with the shot clock expiring. Off the mark, but Oviedo skies for the rebound there to reset for the Blue Angels. Blue Angels reset the offense again as Richardson on the elbow. Looked to drive there. It looks like she got fouled by, looks like it's going to be called on Jordan Widener.
Oviedo's wearing a different number this half. Must have got a little bit of blood on it when she went out with that elbow.
Yeah, now wearing number 24. Originally number 12 is Onan, puts up the jumper off the inbound. That one's in and out and taken down by the Sabres. Here's Bobbin again. She swings over to Widener. Fast-paced offense here for the Sabres as they look to drive and kick. Bauman now on the top of the key, kind of resets. There's Brandy Bender with the drive and the layup with the left hand.
Tough task for Oviedo there as she's played 19 minutes so far. She's getting a little tired.
Here's the Blue Angel offense here as Rungi has the ball. So Oviedo now wearing the 24. As she goes behind the back, kind of loses the handle. And another scramble for the ball.
Looks like the Blue Angels have gone back to what they were doing at the beginning of the first quarter, which wasn't as successful as what they started to do later on in the first and second quarter, where they swung it around the outside more. They're leaving Onan inside, and it's hard to get her the ball.
Yeah, very stingy defense here so far for the Sabres, as it looks like we had a shot clock. I don't know if it was a shot clock violation or just a jump ball, and the possession arrow went. Looks like it was a jump ball, so the possession arrow to the Sabres. As Widener here drives baseline, gets around Onan, but Onan with the rejection and the rebound there by Becky. Nice play defensively by Becky Onan.
Yeah, let her feel like she was going to have an open lane in the basket, and using her height to her advantage, gets the block and rebound.
Now the ball stole away from Rungi as Paulus drives and kicks.
Another block by Onan.
Another good defensive play on the scramble there by the Blue Angels. As the Blue Angels will reset. Mark Heidorf runs the offense. As here's Swafford off the screen by Richardson. Off to Oviedo. Oviedo looks to create. Spin move by her. Here's Richardson. Foot on the line. No good. Rebounded by Bender. Bauman now defended by Richardson. Off to Paulus. That three-pointer is good by Nicole Paulus.
Her and Bauman have really been the only two that the Blue Angels have let succeed on the court, and they're paying for that right now as both are in double digits.
Yeah, both in double digit scoring now for the Sabres. As Richardson drives baseline, she's bodied up by Widener and now stripped by Widener. Pretty good defensive play there by Jordan Widener, the 5'5 freshman from Union Grove. Bauman again for three. She's been open in that corner. She knocks down another triple for the Sabres.
Bauman by far having a career game today, up to 17 points so far, and there's still 15 minutes left in the game.
Yeah, so far so good for Brittany Bauman, the sophomore from Neenah, as Coach Mark Heidorf of the Blue Angels will look to call a timeout.
For the Blue Angels, Oviedo has been creating a lot of opportunities. They just haven't knocked down the shot so far, and I think she's really got to be your starter of your offense. Onan hasn't been able to get free so far, but Oviedo's been able to drive to the hole and kick to Richardson quite a few times, along with the rest of the team, but she's really been the only one able to create so far through 2.5 quarters.
Yeah, she's done a good job of getting into the paint and then dishing it off to those open teammates once the defense, rotates over and tries to stop her from getting into the lane. She's finding open teammates. The problem is they're just not knocking down the shots.
Do you expect Mount Mary to go back to the 2-1-2 pressure?
I can see it happening. I know Coach Heidorf likes to use it. I think it did work pretty well there in the first half. They used it on and off there in the second quarter and even late in the first quarter, and really kind of stalled the offense for the Sabres. So I wouldn't be surprised if we saw that again. The problem is they have to use that and get a scoring opportunity from that pressure.
Yeah, the second quarter was definitely a good defensive quarter for the Blue Angels as they gave up 14 total points and scored 8 themselves, but now they've given up 11 points in the first 5 minutes. Haven't really used that 2-on-2 pressure except for the first possession of the second half, and I think it's something they have to go back to keep up the high pressure, even though they have a short bench, and it's tiring out the team.
We're set for action again as ball's inbounded by Mount Mary. Out of bounds. We do have a couple substitutions now for Mary University. Checks into the game along with Hunter Godfrey. Looks like we might have a media timeout here. Just under 5 minutes to play. Marion leads this one 44-12 in the third quarter.
The Blue Angels have definitely come into their offense a little bit more in the second and third quarter. They haven't started to knock down the shots yet, but I think you have to look positives at they're getting those opportunities. It's just with those opportunities, eventually you're going to start knocking down the shots, and they just haven't come so far yet today.
Yeah, absolutely. Do you think that the Blue Angels will look to get owning the ball? She's been a key contributor so far this season for the Blue Angels, but so far this afternoon, just 4 points. Pretty poor shooting percentage. Do you think that they'll look to get her the ball?
I think that's the obvious choice to go to Onan, but I think what could happen and what would be more effective is if you use Onan as a distraction, which she has been for most of the day, but have her facilitate to Oviedo. Oviedo is 2-4 from the field. She's been creating opportunities, and it seems like she has the best ability so far to go into the paint and get to the hole and maybe cause some foul and free throw shots going on in this game.
We'll see if it happens here for the Blue Angels. Looks like we're about set ready for action. Again, just under 5 minutes remaining in the third quarter here at the Bleckel Center. As Oviedo will inbound to Runge. Off the screen by Onan. And now off to Swafford. Oviedo again. Pass is tipped. Gathered by Runge. And now Oviedo into the lane. She floats one up off the rim. No good. Onan comes down with the rebound. And she is fouled. Good offensive rebound there by Becky Onan. And like you said, a good creation there by Oviedo to get into the lane.
Yeah, she definitely seems a little, not that the others are hesitant, but she seems a little more aggressive. And when she sees that opening, she's cutting to it and going to the hole and trying to make contact and get that layup to go in. That one off the back of the rim. But a good opportunity for the Blue Angels.
Taylor York checks in for the Blue Angels as Runge off the screen by Onan, and she gets all the way to the cup.
Looks like it's becoming a little contagious for the Blue Angels to start cutting in the hole as through the second and third quarter so far, they've been a lot more aggressive in getting to the paint.
Here's the Sabres now as they work the offense. Widener on the dribble. She kicks off to Kavark. That's Godfrey with the jumper. Foot on the line, so just a two, but a good shot there by Hunter Godfrey, the sophomore from Oakfield, Wisconsin. Oviedo will drive baseline, but before that, it looks like they've got a traveling violation called. She looked to create, but a little bit too quick with the feet.
Yeah, she had the opening there on the left side. She's not afraid to use either hand, as we've seen so far, and had the right idea, just jumped a little too quick.
Here's Paulus on the wing. She brings it back out to the top of the key. As Godfrey looks, here is Widener in the corner. A lot of movement there by the Sabres on their offense so far this afternoon. As Widener will look baseline off the fake. Her shot's no good off the front of the rim. And pulled down by Oviedo.
Yeah, and good rotation there by Oviedo as she stepped down to stop the driver and forced her to throw up a floater.
Oviedo now off the screen by Onan. She looks to create in the lane. Floater off the back of the rim a couple times and gets it to fall. Good play there again by Oviedo.
Last three possessions from the Blue Angels have been really good as they've gotten in the hole and had a good chance at a layup.
A good pass there by Nicole Paulus, so she finds Widener for the layup.
Yeah, that's not much you can do defensively there. Widener just made a good cut in the middle of the rotation and found the paint, easy layup.
Runge off to Swafford. And Onan at the top of the key. Here's Oviedo over to Runge. Runge fakes. Kicks to Swafford. She drives and is stripped by Paulus. Paulus brings it up. And she's met by Runge at the timeline.
Good pressure by Runge there. She almost forced a 10-second violation, and it really just disrupted the ball carry.
Yeah, she's had the task today of guarding Nicole Paulus, who's been the leading scorer for Marion this young season. As she comes off the screen, her jump shot's a little short. The shot clock did not reset for the Sailors. But a good play there. Looks like Widener will go to the line as she drove to the hole and got the foul called.
Widener yet to attempt a free throw yet today, but did have 4 points in the first half.
That foul was called on Becky Onan, her first personal foul this afternoon, as Widener puts in the first one. Checking in for the Blue Angels, number 10, Shandrika Richardson, and 32, Taja Williams. Check back in for the Blue Angels, as Widener will go to the line for one more. That one rattles in. Score here with under 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Marion leads it here 50-16.
Widener making her presence felt so far with that nice cut to the basket, plus two free throws, so she's already up to 4 points this half and eight total.
Well, good play there by Widener again as she strips Oviedo on the drive. And she finds Hunter Godfrey as she is fouled in the paint.
Widener's been really composed for a freshman, only in her second game of her collegiate career, and she's making a big impact.
Yeah, absolutely. One of the few newcomers for Marion this year that really playing a good game today. As Godfrey at the line, she connects on the first. Here's the second. That one's off the rim, and Onan Skies gets the rebound there after a good battle. Onan will set. Here's Richardson off the screen. Runge wanted to line it up, thought about it. Now kicks to Oviedo. Oviedo for three off the back of the rim. And it looks like we have a loose ball foul called on 32, Taja Williams. Her second personal foul.
I like the aggressiveness so far, though, in the second half from the Blue Angels. It hasn't turned into a lot of points yet, but it's something to build on in the future. They've really done a nice job of finding open looks more here, more so far in the second half.
As Paulus knocks down another triple from the corner, as it extends the lead to 54-16. Under a minute remaining here in the third quarter. Swung around now, here's Richardson. Runge back to Richardson now. Oviedo, Onan, should look to drive.
Looks like there might have been a little bit of a foul there on Onan's drive, but loose ball goes out and becomes Sabres' ball.
Yeah, no call there by the referee. Coach Mark Hardoff really wanted a foul called there, but unfortunately we're not able to get the foul. Under 30 seconds remaining here in the third quarter as the Sabres look to work the offense. Paulus with the loose ball somehow finds Godfrey in the paint for a bucket.
And another good cut by a Sabres player to the middle of the paint and finding the hole in the Blue Angels defense.
Richardson goes baseline, gets around Paulus. She throws up the shot, but before the shot, we've got the foul call. That one is on Nicole Paulus for the Sabres. Her second personal foul as we've got 4 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. Onan will look to drive. She puts it up, and that one hits the back of the rim and in. Good play there by Becky Onan as the third quarter ends.
Yeah, much better quarter for Onan in terms of her overall performance. In the first half, she was still making a factor on the defensive end, rebound and blocks. But in this third quarter, she scored 4 points, had a couple blocks, a couple rebounds, and starting to make her presence known out there on the court.
Yeah, she looked a lot more comfortable here in this third quarter. Our score after three, Marion leads it here 56-18.
Sabres got back to that three-pointer in the third quarter and started knocking them down again, where they only shot 33% in the first half. But first quarter for Marion, as we said earlier, they had to be 5 of 7 or so from three, and they just struggled in the second quarter.
Yeah, the offense really was turned up there by Marion University in that third quarter. A lot of scoring from a variety of players, really, for the Sabres.
Yeah, a big 23-point quarter for Marion, their biggest quarter yet. First quarter they had 19, second quarter scored 14, so they really exploded there in the third to go up and extend their lead.
Yeah.
And offensively, a good quarter for Mount Mary as well. It's just a big hole they have to do a lot to come back from, and just trying to chip away is tough to do when you're in that big of a deficit.
Yeah, the Blue Angels almost matched their first half total in points, scoring 8 here in the third quarter after having just 10 in the first half, so good output there by the Blue Angels. Looks like we're about set to go for the fourth quarter. We'll reset the lineup here quickly for the Blue Angels. Runge is out there with Onan and Williams, along with Richardson and Oviedo round out the five for the Blue Angels. For Marion, it looks like we've got new faces here. Let's see if we can reset it here as Richardson lines up a triple. That one is good. Three-point bucket by Richardson.
Blue Angels are definitely starting to create more openings around the arc and on the inside as they've started to knock down a couple shots.
We'll reset it here for Marion as Samantha Smith is out there with number 12, Brandy Bender. That is Lindsay Vogel's inside, as she doesn't get that one to go. She's out there with Christina Salmon, seeing her first minutes of today's game, sophomore from Campbell's Court, Wisconsin, along with Sarah Schultz, a freshman from Seymour, Wisconsin, getting her first action here in the fourth quarter. Do we have a travel called there?
Yeah, it was interesting. Oh, I'm not really sure how it was called a travel, because I'm pretty sure Onan had the ball, and the Blue Angels retained the ball, so I'm unsure of what the call was now, looking at the results.
Yeah, yeah. Either way, we got it. We've got a timeout called by Coach Mark Heidor for the Blue Angels, with still over 9 minutes remaining here as we get the fourth quarter underway.
The starters for the Blue Angels are definitely playing a lot of minutes, and it's got to be wearing them down, but they've done a good job of keeping that high-level energy that they started the game with.
Yeah, and it's I think it's kind of a given, you know, if we got seven players on a roster, I feel like a lot of people are going to be playing a lot of minutes. But like you said, I think there's a couple players on the Blue Angels lineup that haven't come out of the game so far. I know Onan hasn't come out, and I believe Runge hasn't checked out of the ball game either so far today.
Yeah, four of the five that started the game played 19 or 20 minutes in the first half. The only one that didn't was Yort, as she played 13. So really, the subs have been going in for one player, and the rest of the team hasn't been able to get a break, but they've done a good job of keeping the high energy and playing hard throughout the entire game.
Yeah, it's a really test for their their determination and their effort. If you're playing 40 minutes nonstop, that's tough on the players, and so it's good to see that everybody's still giving a lot of effort as we start this fourth quarter.
Yeah, whereas for the Sabres, they only had one player in Jordan Winder, the freshman guard, who played 17 minutes. Everybody else was 15 or less, so they got some breaks in there. Even 2 minutes makes a big difference in the term of a 40-minute game.
And I think that's where Coach Mike Heidefler likes to use his timeouts, just to give people a break like that. He knows his limitations with his roster, and I think he uses those timeouts pretty well. We're set back for action as Oviedo gets it inside to Onan. Onan faces up, now back out to Runge. Runge will look baseline. Good defensive pressure by the Sabres as the ball swung around. Richardson creates, finds Oviedo. That layup's no good. Her putback off the mark as well, as the Sabres bring it up the court.
And another good take by Oviedo, and a good find by Richardson to find her on the cut and giving her the time to actually get to the hole and have a good chance at an easy layup.
Schultz with the pump fake. And before the shot, we've got a travel called on Sarah Schultz, as the ball will go with Mount Mary. Taylor York checks back in for the Blue Angels. Here's Onan now off to Rungi. To Richardson, back out to Oviedo. Oviedo will drive baseline. Onan no good, but she gets her own rebound. Out to Onan for three. She lines up the triple.
If you're Coach Heidorf, you have to be happy with what you've seen from Oviedo definitely in this game so far. She's been really aggressive and created a lot of opportunities for the rest of the team.
As that three-pointer is off the mark, another rebound pulled in by Ariel Oviedo. As she'll set the offense back up, off the screen now from Onan. To Rungi. Rungi looks inside, now decides to drive. Her layup off the glass is good. Pretty good output so far offensively for the Blue Angels in this fourth quarter.
Blue Angels are definitely starting to find a rhythm on offense, and they're starting to knock down some shots.
As that three-pointer is off the mark by Brandi Bender, pulled in by Becky Onan. And we've got a foul called on number 12, Brandi Bender. A little too much contact there for the referee.
Yeah, something we talked about earlier in the hand checks, how they're really trying to cut down on that and make you actually shuffle your feet, which makes defense a lot tougher for the majority of players.
Yeah, we've seen a lot of rule changes in the last couple of years where it really benefits the offense more than the defense. We talked about the offense and the play clock or the shot clock, and instead of two halves, now we got four quarters, and that's just another rule change with that hand check, as the ball is tipped out of bounds. And it looks like possession will go with the Sabres.
Good hustle there by Schultz for the Sabres to really, that ball looked like it was going to be Blue Angels' ball, and she hits it off of Taylor York and gets the ball back for the Sabres.
Now the Sabres work the offense as Smith lines up a three. That one's off the glass, no good. Onan grabs another rebound there. York handles the pass there by Rungi. Now back to Rungi off the screen. She kicks to Richardson. Richardson on the one dribble pull-up. Off the front of the rim. And deflected out of bounds. Last touch by the Sabres. Onan will look to inbound here. As she finds Richardson at the top of the key, she lines up a triple. Off the back of the rim. Battle for the rebound pulled down by Lindsay Vogels of the Sabres.
It's a long three there by Richardson as she was a few steps behind the three-point line, but if you're wide open, I guess why not take the shot?
Yeah, exactly. And I think really at this point, any offense will be welcomed by Coach Heidorf. As the ball stripped there by Jess Rungi. Good defensive play there by the Blue Angels. Rungi now sets up the offense. Almost threw it away, but Becky was there. Onan to Richardson. Now Rungi again. Onan lines up a triple. That one's a little long. And it looks like it wasn't touched before going out of bounds. It'll be Sabres ball.
She has started to take those three-pointers, though, which I think could be useful down the stretch. Is she's not a bad three-point shooter.
Yeah.
And being a forward, most teams won't come out on her until they see her knock down a couple, and she can use that to her advantage at the beginning of games and in the first half.
Yeah, and being the tallest player for the Blue Angels, you're right. Most people won't step out to guard that three-point attempt. She'll have some open looks for herself. Looks like we might have a change of possession. Looked like it was going to be Sabres ball, but I'm hearing it's last touched by the Sabres. The referee just at the scorer's table confirming.
And I think we're ready to go here. It'll be Blue Angels ball off the inbound.
18 seconds on the shot clock, so still plenty of time to run your offense here.
As Onan drives in, she throws one up off the mark. Scramble for the loose ball on the rebound. And a little bit out of control there. We got a loose ball foul called on Taja Williams, her third personal foul.
There was a big scrum there, and not really sure who was where the ball was.
Yeah.
Like a football pile almost.
Yeah, right. I was going to say a rugby scrum almost.
As Kavarik drives in off the back, rebounded by Christina Salmon, and she is fouled. She will go to the line. Salmon, a 5'9 sophomore from Campbellsport, Wisconsin. Seeing some playing time here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, Coach Peters is doing a good job of getting his bench players and his role players more experience in the game where they have a chance to actually run through the offense and get some good time, whereas most games they might get a minute or two at the end. They can actually play 8-10 minutes here in this game.
Absolutely, as Salmon knocks down her second free throw there. Just over 5 minutes remaining. Our score, 57-26. The Marion University Sabres lead it here. As Runge will look to set up the offense here. Off the screen again by Onan. Out to York. She swings to Onan. Richardson now looks to create. York with the step back. That one's off the front of the rim. It looks like it'll fall out.
Good look there with the fake to the paint to create some space and shoot the step back three, not the probably the shot that Heidorf wants to see most of the time, but good job creating space for you to get an open shot. And
yeah.
The Blue Angels defensively have played really well this quarter. I believe they've only given up 1 point.
Yeah, I think that free throw was the only point scored by the Sabres so far this fourth quarter. As we see a zone now by the Blue Angels. They kick it in. Here's Smits for three. She lines it up. Off the mark, rebounded by Taylor York. Another good possession there by the Blue Angels defensively.
Yeah, and I think Coach Heidorf has done a good job using that zone to help. It really gives you a little bit of a rest as a player, as you don't have to chase your person all the way around.
As Richardson drives into the lane, her shot off the mark. Pretty good move there to create by Shandrika Richardson.
Yeah, a little combination of a Euro step and jump stop put together to get to the hole, and she just a little off on the finish.
As the Sabres look to work their zone offense here, they swing it around the perimeter. Smits looks inside. Here's Kavorik. And we've got an offensive foul call. Looks like Molly Kavorik called for the offensive foul with a hook.
Yeah, another thing I've seen called a lot more lately is they're cracking down on offensive players using that non-dribbling arm to get around the defender.
Looks like it'll go here with Runge now as Blue Angels look to set the offense. Pretty good quarter for the Blue Angels so far, outscoring their opponents. Here's Onan now on the drive baseline. She pulls up to the jumper, no good. Grabs for a rebound. And off the glass, good play there again by Onan.
Yeah, good work to, first of all, to create that shot that she had in the first place, the 10-foot jump shot on the baseline. Dribbled, got by her defender on the right side, and didn't give up on the play and followed her shot to the basket, which is something you can say for all the Blue Angels so far today.
Absolutely. Another timeout called here by Coach Mark Heidorf. About 3.5 remaining here. The Sabres lead it 57-28. But a pretty good quarter here for the Blue Angels, scoring offensively. Outscoring the Sabres so far 10-1 in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, you got to be happy with what they've done so far. They've gotten to the hole. They've started to knock down shots. It's too bad that it started this late in the game, but it's things like this that you build off in a long season. As basketball is a long, grueling season, and with Coach Heidorf, he'll have about a month off in between games from December to January that he'll be able to work on these things and hopefully get the Blue Angels ready for the main part of their schedule in the second half.
Yeah, and while you mentioned that, we'll take a look at the upcoming schedule here for the Blue Angels. They will be at Rockford this Tuesday, November 24th. That game will kick off at 7 p.m. And then the next following game, we'll take a break for Thanksgiving and come back Friday, December 4th. They'll take on Wisconsin Oshkosh in Oshkosh. That game will start at 6 p.m. And then, like you said, they got a month-long break. The next game after that will be a home game January 5th, so almost exactly a month from two games from now until their next game. So time to work on some offense, defense, you know, improvements for the Blue Angels.
Yeah, and definitely you have time to get, with such a small roster, injuries are bound to pop up. I don't know if anybody's dealing with some right now, but over the course of the season, it's good to have a break like that before you really get into the grind after the grind you had of practicing leading up to getting everybody in condition.
Absolutely. Set back to play. Mount Mary works in their zone defense as the Sabres look to swing it around. Here's Widener checking back into the game as the pass is tipped. Scramble for the loose ball again as they got a couple bodies on the floor and a jump ball called. It looks like possession will stay with the Sabres, but good defensive intensity there again by the Blue Angels.
Yeah, and you leave the Sabres with a short shot clock. You can't really do much with 4 seconds, so it's going to be one of those. You just got to play hard for a couple. Didn't even have to really do much as the pass got thrown into Onan's hands, and Blue Angels get the ball.
Again, another good defensive stop there by the Blue Angels. So far this quarter, it's been pretty much all Blue Angels in the fourth. As Richardson throws up a three, that one's off the mark. Rebounded by Salmon for Marion. Here's Widener seeing some playing time here in the fourth quarter as she sets up the offense. Smith's on the wing, back to Widener. Inside now. That's Sarah Smith sliding up the football, and that one is good. Off the assist by Salmon.
Yeah, I want to say that's her first shot attempt of the game as she came in end of the third quarter, beginning of the fourth, and she knocks down a three.
Yeah, good play there by Schultz, the freshman from Seymour. And correction, it was just a two-pointer, so their foot was on the line. It's Onan drives, throws one up off the glass, and rebounded by York, and kicked back out. Looks like the Blue Angels will reset.
Onan definitely seems a lot more comfortable in the second half than she did in the first. She's using her ability to dribble, as you see another good play there by Taylor York.
Yeah, good play there, and a good look by Onan to find her in the block. That's another bucket for the Blue Angels in the corner. About a minute and a half remaining as Christina Salmon puts up a jumper from about 12 feet, gets that one to rattle in. Coming down on 1 minute remaining here in the fourth. Marion leads it here 61-30. But you gotta like the effort here by the Blue Angels in this fourth quarter. A lot of defensive intensity still, even with the game being out of reach.
Yeah, and everybody's continued to play hard. Onan, Rungi, Oviedo have all played close to 40 minutes.
Guess we've got a timeout called.
Obviously, you can see here Coach Peterson's situation wants to work on an out-of-bounds play that he might need it at the end of a game later on in the season.
Yeah, it was kind of a scramble for that timeout.
Yeah, a pretty emphatic call over there from the sideline.
Yeah, they wanted to. It looks like they wanted to move the ball up into the front court. So they wanted to make sure that before the player made any movement in the back court.
Yeah, another rule change there as coaches cannot call timeouts during the actual play now. They can only call when there's a stoppage in play. So like an inbounds, something that coaches have had to adjust to, and the players have to be paying attention to their coach to see if there's something like a timeout that they want to call.
Yeah. Just under a minute here remaining in the Bleckel Center as Marion will inbound here. Let's see if they've got a play they've been working on. As the ball was inbounded to Kaporik, she lost the dribble and a turnover there. Grabbed by York.
Yeah, looks like a pretty simple just use your size to get in on the post and get the advantage, and she just lost the handle.
Loose ball is about picked up by Widener. And we have another timeout called.
Good effort by Richardson on trying to get the loose ball. And another timeout called by Coach Peters as he obviously wants to work on this inbounds play a little bit more. Taking a full timeout makes me wonder if they didn't run the play correctly the time before, as it didn't really seem like there was much of a play. It was more of just a box out and receive the ball.
Yeah. We'll see if they have something more strategic this second time out. Well, we got a sec. What are your takeaways from today's game as we wind down here?
I really think for Coach Heidorf, you have to build off of what you saw from Onan, Oviedo, and Richardson in the second half, as they were, and Rungi, they were all a lot more aggressive and seemed more comfortable and went to the hole, started to knock down shots and find their range, really. Whereas in the first half, there was a lot of, they'd go up and they'd lose the ball on the way up. Here, they stayed strong and they got to the hole. And the defense has been really good in the second and fourth quarter. You just got to translate that to the first and third.
Yeah, see if they can get that going for the last four quarters, put together a complete game, and possibly come out with a victory next time out.
Yeah, still young on the season as well. It's only the fourth game of the year. Still have a lot of games left and a lot of minutes to be played, so you just got to build off what you can so far.
Sabres work the offense as the shot clock is turned off. So we might have our last possession here as Widener swings the ball around. Here's Schultz. Still good pressure here by the Blue Angels as the time runs down. We're under 10 seconds. And it looks like Marion will just hold out for the end of the game here. There you have it. Our final score, Marion University 61 and Mount Marion University 30. Any last takeaways before we sign off here, Brett?
I think you just got to be pleased if you're Mount Mary with the effort your players have put in so far, and you got to hope that continues throughout the rest of the season. The shots are going to start to drop as you get into the season. Onan, as we said earlier, she played soccer. She hasn't been off for that long, so she might not have the touch she will have later on in the season, but you got to build on what you have so far.
Nicely said there, Brad. All right, we'll sign off here. Again, our final score, Marion University 61, Mount Mary University 30. Catch us next time on MountMaryAthletics.com. Our next scheduled game, home game, will be January 5th, but you can always catch our stats, live stats, on our website here. Again, my name is Clint Andreessen with my partner, Brett Burke. Thank you again, and we'll talk to you later.